Hello there, welcome to my channel, Var redo, or be ready, as it would translate into English, because this channel is about being ready for adventures or emergency preparedness. I'm out hiking today on a trail called Sörmlandsleden. It's 1,000 kilometers long. But I'm walking on section 8. My aim is to hike about 20 kilometers today. This morning, I was charging my drone batteries and from my power bank, Power Traveler Solar Adventure 2, and it went dry. I totally emptied the power bank. So now it's on my backpack here. About an hour ago it was kind of sunny, but now it's it's partly cloudy anyway. So let's see if I can charge the power bank anything during these conditions. It's actually October 18th 2020, and I'm in Sweden, and we have pretty short days now, but they are getting crazy short soon. Actually, up in the north, the sun barely rises during the winter, but we have a few hours of light anyway during the winter here. Well, enough about Sweden. I guess most of my viewers are Swedes anyway, but I thought to myself after looking at Mattias Eriksson's videos, because he makes all his videos in English, and I thought, well, why not make a video in English now and then? So here's one. Okay, came into a field here. It was such a nice weather for 5 minutes. So this is the Power Traveler Solar Adventure 2. I have added these this bank line myself, just to tie it on the backpack so it doesn't dangle around too much. It's pretty small, I guess. It has one USB-C and one regular USB port here. It, if you press this button here, you can see it needs to be charging because the bottom light is flashing here. And then you have five LEDs here. If the bottom LED is lit, it's 25% left in the battery.
50, 75 and fully charged. And the top one here is a red one. So when the solar panel gets in contact with a light source, it lit up. It illuminates like that. I'm not sure how much is actually charging now, but not too much, I guess, because it's cloudy at the moment. Battery capacity is 10,000 milliamps or 37 watt hours. That's probably a better measurement. I purchased this because I needed a power bank to charge the drone batteries faster. Today I use a 12 volt charger and a big power gorilla to charge the drone batteries. The drone batteries are like 11 volt or something, 11 volts. But this one can actually charge two drone batteries for a DJI Spark, and it's fast. So if I want to fly a lot with the drone and need to charge them up, I can do that pretty fast now using this one. It actually charges up to 12 volts when I charge the drone battery. And I can use just the USB cable directed to the drone instead of using the 12 volt battery charger. So it's less things to carry. So that's very, I appreciate that. The only downside with this one is the small solar cell. The solar panel is very small. It's like 3 watts or something. So if you are hiking, I wouldn't depend on this solar panel to recharge this power bank every day. But if you have like if you need it like once a week, it could work if it's pretty sunny. But or if you want to have one of these power banks as a backup at home, and you can actually leave it in a window until it's fully charged and then you close it, that's fine. So I do see the advantage of having this relative small solar panel. Although when it's cloudy and this time of year here in Sweden, I prefer a larger solar panel to charge my batteries. But overall, I'm very satisfied with this one so far. I've used a lot of other power traveler, I have other power traveler products also. Two solar panels and one big power gorilla, which I use a lot, and they work fantastic. So I'm looking forward to using this more. And I bought this with my own money, so I'm not sponsored by any means. This has been placed in my backpack since 10 past 10 this morning. And when I get back home, I'll see how much the battery is charged, actually, and measure that. This is the third time I'm filling up the burner, actually. It's cold. It's probably colder than it seems, and it's windy.
Okay, so here's the Solar Adventure 2. It's been facing south for 3 days now, and now it's stopped charging, as you can see. Now it's time for me to go home and see how much the batteries charge during these 3 days in cloudy weather. If I press this button here, it doesn't look very good. I've placed this solar cell or the power bank facing south for 3 days in mostly cloudy weather, and there is no power to measure in the power bank.
Om du gillar den här videon, ge en tummen upp, skriv gärna en kommentar nedanför och prenumerera jättegärna på kanalen. Ha det bra. Hej.